Hello everyone, welcome to my class. I'm Ivy. Nice to see you again. Yes, today what we are going to learn in Chinese? Yes, of course you don't know it, but I would like to ask you a question. When you go to China, what is the first place that you have arrived? Okay, except the airport, okay? So where? Exactly, hotel. So when you are go to the hotel, you will meet a lot of problems and questions. And so how to speak in Chinese? Hotel, how to say in Chinese? 酒店 is hotel, okay? So when you arrive in the hotel, hotel entrance, how to say in Chinese? 酒店门口, entrance is 门口, okay? 门口 is entrance, 酒店门口 is hotel entrance, okay? So what is reception? Reception, how to say it? This one is very important, right? You have to keep in mind. Reception is 前台, very good. So, how to say elevator or lifts in Chinese? 电梯, one more time. You can meet this one, this word everywhere. Even you go shopping or hotel, or you live in the home state. Everywhere you have to meet this word. So please repeat after me. 电梯, very good. How about the restaurant in the hotel? The restaurant is 餐厅, yes. The standard room, when you want live in the standard room, how say standard room? The long, very long, right? It's 标准间, yes, very long. Room is a 间, so 标准 is a standard. 标准间, one more time. 标准间, very good. But we have a short form of that. Look at my mouth carefully and listen to my pronunciation, okay? 标间, one more time. 标间, okay? I speak Beijing language, let me feel it. 标间, you see the difference? One more time. Mandarin, 标间, the Beijingese, 标间, see it? Yes, very good. So how about the single room? Single room, 单间, single is a 单, 间 is a room. So 单间, Beijing language, Beijing Hua is 单间, look at my mouth, 单间, yes, very good. So double room, 标间, single room, 单间, very good. So how about the doorman? Easy, right? 门童, door is 门童 is doorman. 门童, okay? Hotel, attendant. 酒店服务员, hotel is always 酒店. So attendant is 服务员, but if like in the restaurant or in the cafe bar, we say waitress or waiter. That is called also 服务员. Let me speak faster, fluently in Chinese, and you feel it, okay? 服务员. Yes, 服务员. This one, the last word, 员, is light. So you have to say 服务员. You see? 服务, You are? Yes. Look at my mouth. 服务员 Yes. Very good. How about cleaner? 保洁员保洁员 Yes. Hotel manager. Hotel. How to say it? Yes. 酒店 right? Manager is 经理 Manager is 经理 So hotel manager is 酒店经理 See it? 酒店经理 Right? So manager is 经理 Hotel manager is 酒店经理 Yes. Now we learn some basic word in the hotel. So you see, oh, I learned so many. I don't know how can I use it. I don't know when I can use it. Yes. In this situation, learn communication is very important. Okay, we did learn a lot of words. You say, ah, I can't remember it. I want to apply it. That is more useful. Yes, here we are. Booking hotel. How say booking hotel in Chinese? 订酒店 Yes, one more time. 订酒店 Yes, how say I want to book a hotel? You know it? Yeah. 我想订酒店 Or I book a hotel. 我订酒店 Perfect. Yes, you see, now you can see the sentences, right? Yes, very good. So, I will act two roles for you, and then you can see the conversation, okay? So, you see a lot, right? No problem, just a little after I talk, okay? So, the first will be A. Hello, I'd like to book a hotel. Book a room in a hotel. Yes, how to say it in Chinese? Remember hello? Yes. 你好, very good. I would like to book 我想 book room 订 book is 订我想订 a room 一个房间 very short right this is so long but this one is very short so how to say it if you want to book a room in your hotel yes 你好我想订个房间 hello I would like to book a hotel book a room in a hotel yes one more time okay 你好我想订个房间 Very good. But what the people will answer you? Right? They will say, hello, there is. Right? If there is, how to say it? 你好有房间 Right? 你好有 It means, yes, there is. Right? They will ask you, would you like to have a single room? Standard room or single room? Do you remember how to say in Chinese? Yes, single room and standard room. Remember it, okay? So, 请问, would you like, 请问你需要标间还是单间? Yes, you want single room or standard room, okay? Whole sentences, okay? 你好有，请问你想要标准间、标间还是单间 ？Yes. See, one more time. We make these two conversation. Okay. 你好，我想订个房间。你好，有，你想要标准间还是单间 ？Easy, right? Wow, we finish a half already. A half, only two sentences. Easy, right?If you can't remember it, you can write down in your paper or do the screencast for that and remember how to say practice. And then if you want to book a hotel in China, you can try to use these two sentences. Try to use it and let you know, and then you will know your pronunciation is correct or not, right? So, and then you say single room, please. How to say single room? Yes.Dan jian, right? Very good. So, after you say dan jian, what do you have to say? Yes, thank you. 谢谢, dan jian, 谢谢, right? Yes. How much is that? Of course, you have to ask. So, dan jian, 谢谢. 请问 多少钱 ？Yes， 单间谢谢，请问多少钱 ？Every times when you ask the people, you always have to say 请问。That is very polite, you know. So you say 请问多少钱 ？Yes, very good. And they tell you the. Do you still remember how to say the numbers in Chinese? Yes, 178.一百七十八块 ，right? Or yuan, 一百七十八块一天 ，right? Per day, 一百七十八块一天 ，right? Okay, so now I show you the whole slides one more time in Chinese only. You listen carefully, and you can follow me.You can follow me or you can read after me. Okay, I will speak very slow. Okay? 你好，我想订一个房间。你好，有，请问是标准间还是单间？单间，谢谢。请问多少钱？一百七十八块。每天。See it? Do you follow me? If you can't follow me, no problem. You can remember it or you can write down and practice after the class. Okay? Very good. So, continue the conversation. Okay? Continue the conversation.After they tell you how much per day, so what you are going to say? You say, okay, you will tell them, okay, I'd like to book a room, thanks. 好的，请给我订一间房，谢谢。请给我订一间房，谢谢。You already agree with the price, so you say, 好的，请给我订一间房，谢谢。Okay? So, and then they will tell you,好的，订好了 ，right？ 请在晚上八点前，八点 8 p.m. right？ p.m. is night， so it's 晚上 ，right？ 晚八点前入住 ，it means check in。check in is 入住 ，OK？ So you can say 好的，订好了，请在晚上八点前入住。Check in is 入住 ,OK? So, and what did I say? 好，谢谢。Easy, right? So, I will talk slowly the same, and then you can follow me, OK? So, 好的，请给我订一个房间，谢谢。好的，订好了。请在晚上八点前入住。好，谢谢。Good? Yes? But okay, you also can say it in China, and most of people, they know okay means okay. How about check-in? When you check-in, also very important, right? But how to say check-in, do you remember? Yes, 入住。入住 very good. 入住 When you come to the hotel, you want to check in. What do you have to say? Yeah, you just book the room, right? Yeah, you have to say, hello, I book a hotel, I book a room online or on the phone, right? So what I say? Hello, yes, one more time. 你好，我已经在网上网上 is online. 网上 means online. On the phone is 电话里 On the phone is 电话里 Right? 预定 means booked. 预定了一个房间 Okay? I hope I read the whole sentence for you. Okay? 你好，我已经在网上预定了一个房间。OK, 你好，我已经在电话里订了一个房间。 Yes. So the reception will, okay, let me check. What, how they say? How the, let me check. Is it, 让我查一下? Yes. Please tell me your name or phone numbers. Sense. Is there anyone can speak this sentence or do you know how to say name in Chinese? I will tell you. So, 请告诉我, please tell me, 请告诉我, 你的名字, name is 请告诉我你的名字, 或者, is or, 或者电话, phone, 号码, 号码 is number. So, 请告诉我你的名字, 或者电话号码. Okay? It's two sentences, very long, but it's very, very useful, okay? Try to remember it. I will repeat one more time. So, 你好,我已经在网上订了一个房间. Yes. 你好,我已经在电话里订了一个房间. Yes. So, how to say it? 你好,好的,我查一下, right? Let me check, 我查一下. Okay, so, 请告诉我你的名字或者电话号码. Okay, 请告诉我你的名字 或者电话号码. Very good. Have to remember this. Very, very useful. And we say, 是的. Right? Yes, sir or madam. You have booked a room. Please show me your ID card or passport. Thanks. Yes, they will say, 是的. 先生, sir, is 先生, madam, 女士, 先生 or 女士, very important. 你预定了房间, 请出示, show, it means 出示, 出示, 你的身份证, 身份证 is ID card, okay? 你的, yours, 你的身份证, 身份证, 你的身份证, or, how to say, 或者, yes, 或者, passport, how to say, 护照, one more time, 护照, yes, 谢谢. Very important, remember 护照, eh? Because later when you go to hotel or go to the Chinese airport, ever they need your passport and you have to understand how to say it in Chinese. 护照, okay? I talk this whole sentence one more time. You follow me, okay? You can repeat when after I say, okay? 是的,先生,女士,你预定了房间, 请出示你的身份证。 证或护照，谢谢. Yes, okay. I speak fluency one more time. You can feel it by your ear. Okay. So, 是的，先生、女士，你预定了房间，请出示你的身份证或者护照，谢谢. You see? Can you feel it? Why every times I have to speak fluency one more time in Chinese, because I want you feel it, how the Chinese people talk. It's not only that you can talk. Sometimes that if you go out, you think you can speak Chinese, but when you go out, you meet China, they speak faster a little bit, and you won't understand. So I want you feel it and compare. And then, so later when you come to China or you talk to the Chinese people, you can understand more than. Okay? Your room is in the floor 3110. There is your room card. Yeah, how to say it? Your room. Room is 房间, right? So, 你的房间. Yes, the floor. 在三层. Floor is a 层. How to say? Read the numbers. You can read the numbers only during 三一零. Yes.你的房间在三层三一零 or 三 you remember? I told you one in the number, yes, 幺 right? 三幺零 yes. 这是你的房卡 room card, 房卡 okay? So I speak one more time. 你的房间在三层三一零这是你的房卡 okay?So, I speak this too. You can feel it. 是的，先生、女士，你预定了房间，请出示你的身份证或是护照，谢谢。你订你的房间在三层三一零，这是你的房卡。OK, easy, right? So after.You live in the hotel and you want to check it out. You want to check out. What are you going to say? Yes. How to say check it out in China? In Chinese, 退房. 退房 is check it out. It means that I'm going to return the room. Yes. 退房. Okay. 退房. Yes. Hello. I'd like to check out. Thanks. Easy. Hello. 你好. I.我要退房，谢谢。Very easy, very simple, right? 你好，我要退房。Yes. Please show me your room card, thanks. 请出示你的房卡，谢谢。Wow, you guys so polite, right? Every time you say 谢谢, thanks, and then the people, they are willing to answer your question and help you, you know.You have stayed in the room in the hotel for 2 days. You have to pay this amount of money, right? So, how to say? 你住了两天, right? It's 2, it's 两天, right? 你共一共 how to say? 三百四十元, yes.一共三百四十元，谢谢。你住了两天，一共三百四十元，谢谢。OK, so one more time. 你好，你好，我要退房，请出示您的房卡，谢谢。你住了两天，一共三百四十元，谢谢。Very good. Oh, you see.Oh, many times, three times, 谢谢. Oh, so polite. In China, we have one sentence that if you always polite to others, and the people will willing to help you. So when you come to China, or when you want to ask help in China, please remember, after they answer you, or after they help you, say thanks. What is that? 谢谢. Very important.Today, we learn more conversation. Perhaps you think, okay, it's so much. Don't worry. It is easy sentences. You can remember it or write down in your paper and practice all the time. Or you, when you book the hotel in China, try to speak out the sentences that we learned today. I'm sure that will be helpful.Okay, thanks for watching my video. If you like my channel, please hit the subscribe button under. See you next time. Bye.